Millions of years ago, some photosynthetic plants underwent an incredible transformation. They evolved into carnivores by developing their ability to consume meat. However, until recently, most people did not believe that plants ate animals. It was against the natural order. Plants were the source of food, and mobile animals did the eating, not the other way around. However, thanks to the meticulous works of evolutionary biologist Charles Darwin, today we know that some plants are not as innocent as they appeared. In his works, Darwin showed the leaves of some plants, which had been transformed into ingenious structures, that not only trapped insects and other small creatures, but also digested them. He in fact called this a carnivorous syndrome. Since then, researchers have identified more than 800 meat-eating plants. Welcome to the Isle of Knowledge. Today we are going to explore the fascinating world of carnivorous plants. Carnivorous plants are distinguished from other flowering plants because of their ability to trap, kill, and utilize the nutrients from the captured prey. The prey is usually attracted to the plant by specialized leaves or traps, which may function as active or passive, depending on whether the movement is involved in the capture. But why do they consume insects and small invertebrates? As you already know, nitrogen is an essential component of amino acids, the building blocks of proteins, and nucleic acids, which are the building blocks of DNA and RNA. Animals usually obtain nitrogen from the proteins in their diet, which is used for the synthesis of proteins and other necessary compounds. A lack of nitrogen in the diet can result in stunted growth, reduced immune function, and other health problems for animals. Plants, on the other hand, take nitrogen from the soil through the roots and are used for the synthesis of chlorophyll and other important compounds. Lack of nitrogen can limit plant growth and result in the yellowing of leaves. Carnivorous plants have evolved to capture and digest insects, primarily as a way of obtaining the nitrogen and other nutrients they need to grow in nutrient-poor soils. Their ability to use insects as nutritional sources help those plants to grow even in acidic soil, where nutrient levels are low. It is important to know that, like all other plants, carnivorous plants do photosynthesize, but most of their nutrients are taken from trapping and consuming insects. In today's video, we are going to discuss some fascinating stuff about plants that are acting like real killing machines. Carnivorous plants come in various types, and each one has a distinctive method of catching and digesting its food. These plants are intriguing as they show how plants can thrive in harsh conditions, by evolving in special ways to get the nutrients they need. They can be found in diverse habitats such as bogs, swamps, and deserts. Let's delve into some interesting facts about them. Pitcher plants are the ones that modified their leaves to form deep slippery tubes, filled with digestive fluid. These tubes, called pitchers, serve as deadly traps for insects, which are then digested by the plant. There are several types of pitcher plants, primarily found in wet, nutrient-poor environments. The slippery pitcher, combined with downward-pointing hairs, makes it difficult for insects to escape once they have entered the tube. The fluid in the pitcher contains digestive enzymes that break down the insect's body and provide the plant with the necessary nutrients. Depending on the variety, the size of the pitcher plants can be from 6 inches to more than 36 inches tall. Sundews are named for their distinctive leaves, which are covered in sticky, glandular hairs that resemble drops of dew. When an insect landed on a sundew leaf, the sticky hairs entrapped it and the leaf curled around the insect by trapping it. The plant then released digestive enzymes from the glands on the leaf, breaking down the insect and absorbing its nutrients. This is surely a painful experience for those insects, but a necessity for sundews to survive in those environments. Sundews are native to bogs, fens, and other wetland habitats, with nutrient-poor soils, and they are found throughout the world. Sundews are native to sunny, boggy habitats, and their leaves are arranged to look like a sundew, or the rays of the sun. They are available in a range of sizes, from tiny plants less than 2 centimeters tall, to species that can reach up to 60 centimeters in height. Butterworts are handsome, deceptively simple carnivorous plants. They are native to damp habitats in North America, Central America, South America, Europe, and Asia. Like sundews, butterworts also have distinctive, flat leaves that are covered in glandular hairs that secrete a sticky substance to trap insects. Unlike sundews, butterworts are native to damp habitats. Butterworts are also known for their colorful flowers, which come in a range of colors including pink, purple, yellow, and white. The flowers are typically produced on long stems, which help them to attract pollinators with their bright colors and nectar. In Venus flytrap, the trap is the modified leaves that are joined at the midrib and have sensitive hairs on the inner surface. When an insect lands on the trap and touches the hairs, the trap closes quickly by trapping the insect inside. Same as the case of pitcher plants and sundews, once the trap is closed, the insect is trapped inside, and the Venus flytrap begins the process of digestion. There is no doubt that carnivorous plants are deadly to insects and small vertebrates. But, besides killing insects, do they do anything good for our ecosystem? The answer is yes. They do play an important role in the natural world. Carnivorous plants add to the diversity of plant species and play a unique role in their ecosystems, helping to maintain a balance between different species. Many carnivorous plants grow in nutrient-poor environments and have adapted to obtain nutrients from their prey. This helps to maintain the ecological balance in these areas, as the plants can survive where other species would struggle. In addition, carnivorous plants play a role in controlling insect populations in their local environment. Although carnivorous plants are captivating, the world is still brimming with untold secrets and marvels, waiting to be uncovered. If you think that carnivorous plants top the list of nature's bizarre creations, you would be surprised to learn that there are far more surreal and remarkable things out there, which we would definitely feature in our channel. Stay tuned for more. Have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.